deep sea fishing, the most dangerous job in Britain. It's an industry worth £300 million a year.
Winners are never quitters, and quitters are never winners.
In this series, three celebrities are going on a life-changing adventure.
Spit her up already!
I didn't think it would be as dangerous as they said.
It was horrifying.
I must be absolutely barking.
As they join the crew of a British trawler.
There'll be no preferential treatment to those guys.
Really dangerous to go over the edges. Death.
Battling to make money in the brutal North Atlantic.
Shark in the water.
Yeah.
They'll share exhaustion.
Sometimes you gotta hurt to be alive.
The guts and the glory. As they find out what it takes.
Borderline torture.
To catch the fish that feeds Britain. After selling their catch at market, the celebs and the rest of the crew are aboard the trawler Genesis, heading back to sea.
Put down the door handle, Anthony!
Just got so far away.
I was devastated to go back out. Oh, for sake. I was so happy to see land, but it broke up the trip, and, you know, it really did help.
Big morale boost, that was.
Yeah, just so nice to feel on steady ground, really.
Back in human again.
The celebrities' aim for their trip is to catch enough fish for the boat to make a profit.
Can you come up, please, guys?
With the catch so far now sold, Alan has had time to take count and see exactly how things stand.
Was you happy with the fish in the market?
Yeah.
Did you like seeing your work?
Yeah, amazing to see it all laid out like that.
It looked fantastic.
That's good. I've got to break some news to you guys.
What?
You haven't made a single penny yet. Now, all that work you've done up to now, you've paid the commission, landing dues, fuel, oils, provisions.
The catch just has covered the cost of the fuel.
To be honest, I didn't realise how far behind we was. I thought, well, we've just got 2-3 days to get a pay for the guys.
Well, you guys knew it wasn't easy. It wasn't plain sailing. There's a lot of problems.
I know how much I worked for that stuff. I know the hours I put in. I was in pain. I was hurting, absolutely hurting. And then we had only just broke even. We only just covered diesel costs, just covered running costs of the boat, just covered the fact that we'd just been out there for 7 days and none of it actually meant anything. Nobody was going home with anything in their pockets. And that's very disheartening.
So, from now, this is important bit. You're working to pay our guys and you guys.
Right, so we need to drive it on home, push as hard as we can.
Yeah.
Get money on this boat
that's
for the lads.
Actually, that's a message.
Yeah.
No slacking off, you keep going, we just keep going, driving on.
Yeah.
Trying to do our best to catch as much fish as we can and get there, because it's payday time now.
That did put a little, not pressure on us, but it made us zone in for the last bit of the trip. You know, like, why, well, do you know what, this is the guy's money.
I would like to see if we get a nice shot of fresh haddocks and for the end of the week. I think I'll go make good money, to be honest. All right, Chef.
Okay.
You've been excused.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Watch your steps.
Incentive chat.
Yeah.
Come on, Benjamin.
Let's do this.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Hours later, they're back at work. Going all out for the haddock. The large single net is shot out for the 20th haul of the trip. In the hope of a total change in their fortunes.
You have to dig so deep in your own soul to find how to survive in a trip like that. But the men who do it as a living, what drives them inside, I have no idea. is incredible.
A few big hauls of haddock could earn enough money to make a success of the whole trip. But so far, big shoals have been hard to find. In a few hours, they'll know if the gamble has paid off.
You get a lot of time to sit and think, and sometimes they're not all good thoughts, sometimes they're negative thoughts, and you're thinking what you should have done and what you... And you're sitting there torturing yourself, kicking yourself for what you should have done.
You look at any leader, that's a lonely place to make the right decisions, and sometimes, you know, you don't have anyone to talk to. You could see that pressure on Alan's face sometimes.
To find out we'd only broken even, it really sent the message home, brought the message home that this is a tough business. I think for the return, you're putting yourself through so much danger, so much mental strife. It's an incredibly tough business.
Over their 10-day trip, the celebrities hope to catch 1,000 boxes of fish. With 2 days left, they're still 450 boxes short.
I hope it's going to be a good catch. I'm desperate for this to be a good catch. Well, I do every catch, to be fair.
Having covered the boat's costs, the fish they catch from now on will pay the wages of their fellow crew.
Not too bad. Is there a secondary catch?
See how the quality is,
eh? Not much haddock.
But it's another disappointment. Just 17 boxes of haddock, the worst catch of the trip.
You realise how disappointing it is when you see the small kind of hauls coming in and you see that you're not earning the dosh, and you see that the reason why that they want to work those crazy hours is because they have to.
Probably underestimated how far we are behind, to be honest. But it is what it is.
It's not like you can decide to fish at different kind of hours. If they don't put those kind of hours in, they don't earn any money. And that's where I think the torture comes in, because you have to do it. It's not a case of want or a case of, it's you have to actually be a fisherman.
With 2 days of fishing still to go, there's no respite for the celebrities yet.
Go and be a trawlerman for 10 days, then you'll see what artwork is.
It's dawn on day 9. The celebrities are due on deck for what will be their 21st haul of the trip.
What time is it, boys?
5 a.m. All right.
In a last-ditch attempt to hunt down a big catch, Skipper Alan has changed strategy completely. He's steered a course to shallower waters northwest of Orkney in the hope of finding large shoals of haddock.
Oh, that's better.
Beautiful, huh?
Nice calm sea.
Beautiful.
Fishing at this depth is a job for the large single net on the top deck. It's been out for 5 hours.
Yeah.
With less than 600 boxes of fish caught so far, the goal for the trip of 1,000 already seems out of sight. Targeting haddock is the last roll of the dice.
I was under a lot of pressure at that point to do something.
I felt sorry for Alan because he's like a father to that crew. We only had 2 days to make any profit. Otherwise, the crew weren't getting anything.
Straight away, it's clear that a big catch is still eluding them.
No, I know.
But it's not necessarily because they're fishing in the wrong place.
We got here, huh?
The net has been ripped open, allowing most of the catch to escape. Any tears in the net must be mended by hand, and this is the worst one of the trip.
Net got caught up on, ripped a massive big hole in it, basically. Yeah, not a big frustration for sure.
I'm really desperate for fresh now.
Poor buggers.
The remaining catch from the torn net is well short of what they need to get back on track.
There's never enough there. We need something big. We need something really good.
If they carry on fishing here, there's every chance the net will snag again. They have no choice but to move on.
It's going to take whatever we have here as a catch. Steam on. An hour and a half away from this area. Hopefully we get better.
...41-year-old Shane is eager to help out with mending the nets.
Right, Jamie, boss. What's the crack?
Workers and nets torn to bits.
Net mending is a job that takes years to master. First mate Jamie can see that this one tear will take hours to fix.
We'll make finishing it before you haul.
Shane has helped with practical tasks all over the boat, but this is a specialist job. All Shane can do is watch.
Jamie cutting specific knots. Double stitch rope business into single stitch. Now he's actually making the diamond stitch. That's a beautiful bit of artwork there, you know? Far from having a go, this is a bit too intricate, a bit too technical for the likes of me.
With half the crew mending the nets, the pressure is on to make sure the catch is gutted before it spoils. It's a job that Ben struggled to get used to earlier in the trip. Now he doesn't hesitate to get stuck in and to show his support for the skipper.
I'm going to pull it out of the bag. I have no doubt that he will. I just think his personal pride taking a little bit of a battering.
We will be gutting fish on our own because they had problems, but we just knew at that point that we could really make a difference here and help.
A 67-year-old Chef Anthony's knife skills are also proving useful.
You've really got to pull your weight. You know, you can't just be a passenger. You can't expect them to look after you. You're there to do a job.
It's 9 a.m. and the crew need to get back on track. With the torn single net out of action, there's no choice but to revert to the Genesis other system, the twin rig, two side-by-side nets, normally reserved for deeper water.
Hello.
Still going.
But the nets aren't spreading out as they should.
I just wonder if there's something broken, the back of the door somewhere.
The cause of the problem is a mystery.
On here, yeah?
Something really weird. I'm usually pretty good at figuring out something. It's not making sense for me.
So many moving parts. It's never that obvious. It's never like, that's what it is.
If they can't resolve it, Genesis will be left with no other working nets and time running out.
I don't know enough. I'm way out of my depth.
It's mid-morning on day 9. The main net was torn on the first haul of the day. Skipper Allen's last means of making any money is to deploy the boat's twin nets instead. But things are going from bad to worse.
Are they okay with the winches?
Can't I figure it out, Jimmy?
I'm
beginning to think we've got a knock-up doing pump. Means we're knock-ups.
A broken towing pump can cause the net to get seriously damaged underwater. The skipper must decide whether to gamble and carry on fishing with the faulty rig.
36 hours to go.
It's looking pretty hopeless, to be honest.
If his last remaining net gets snagged now, it will be all over for the Genesis.
I think I made quite a few decisions that maybe didn't work in our favour, so I was kind of blaming me for everything at that point.
Would you like a cup of tea?
I'd love a cup of
tea. Do you want a cup of tea?
As a sportsman, Ben knows what it's like to work under pressure.
He wanted to deliver so badly, and it was so personal to him, and you could feel that.
A cuppa for the skipper comes with a team talk that Ben hopes can give Alan's spirits a much-needed boost.
Get used to overcoming problems. Comes second nature at one point, doesn't it?
Yeah. Don't believe we've got longer. Events.
Yeah. But the thing is, you haven't got a lot of time here. You have to deal with it and move on pretty quick.
With one day left to turn things around, it's a vital moment in the trip.
The saving grace is you're not closing two nets or all the nets and we're having to say we're done. Yeah. You've still got one net in the water. You're in the game, mate. You're in the game still.
Still got a fighting chance. I must admit, Ben was good for spurring me on. I don't know if it's a rugby thing, but he's used to working with a team and he enjoys working as a team. He'll be, oh, it's okay, buddy, it's going to turn out fine.
With new hope, Alan decides to trust his instincts and carries on towing the faulty net. As long as it's snag-free, he still has a chance of a big catch. But with the twin net clearly on its last legs, the task of repairing the torn single net becomes an urgent priority. With all hands needed, Shane is drafted in to help by tying on the ball floats that keep the top of the net buoyant.
Now we put this rope around us, and then we tie the balls and dump it on the way down. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Beautiful.
Aye, Shane, he was put up there to do a bit of work a while ago, and he's... I didn't think he was too keen. But now you can see he's enjoying it. He's getting stuck in.
Ah, you're doing grand there.
Go on,
my man.
Beautiful.
We set ourselves to get on that boat and do what they do. There was no special treatment. There was no, we'll sit this one out, lads. There was none of that. We went to be trawlermen.
Shane has dyslexia. While it can cause problems with reading, dyslexics have a different way of seeing practical tasks, which can be very useful on a fishing boat.
When a dyslexic brain engages into a subject, it kind of thinks on a 3D, 4D kind of pattern. So the operation of the boat itself is something I took on board, very much so, and lived it almost.
A guy like Shane will always get on, because the guy's willing to learn.
Trawlermen of the future.
Aye.
Shane's net mending is a triumph. He's even impressed future skipper Philip.
He's picked it up quick. No, it's a grand job.
It's early afternoon, and the hours he's spent mending the single net means Shane heads for a nap just 20 minutes before it's time to rehaul the twin nets.
Okey-dokey, boys. What are you doing?
Rise and Shane.
Where's this going? Back on there?
Anthony and Ben are awake and on deck.
Oh, it's good to see the guys out on the deck helping. came aboard with their squeaky clean gear. A bit of dirt in them, they're looking a bit tired. Bedraggled, maybe. But aye, they're actually beginning to look a bit like Trawlermen now.
We actually got stuck in, you know? We didn't need to be asked, we didn't. We just wanted to do everything.
They really are beginning to impress me now.
But Shane is nowhere to be seen.
Was Shane having a long ride today?
Where's the boy Wonder today?
Shane, he's sleeping. He's given my hand earlier to mend the net.
It's the first time in 9 days Shane has missed the shout to get up for the haul. But Alan has his own onboard alarm clock for lazy crew.
He'll soon be awake anyway when a clump hits the side of his bed. There you go, he's awake now.
Just pull it, mate. Watch your face.
Was that what that meant to watch out?
Quick lash.
I got it
there. With time to make money running out fast, if the Genesis ever needed a big haul, it's now.
Hey, here we go.
The faulty twin nets have been towed for 5 hours, and Alan has spotted some hopeful signs.
I think a fish.
Jimmy, I think we'll maybe just follow bugs as normal. I think there's some fish here.
Earlier in their trip, the celebrities had to throw back large catches of cod. But now they're on the other side of the line, dividing two different fishing areas. Here, the Genesis can keep cod.
Doesn't look bad. Lots of small fish there.
And the net is full of them.
Andy?
Yeah?
You need new glasses. That's not small fish, man.
I do need new glasses. Quite a big fish. You got a bit of cod though, if you don't want. But
you can keep them all this time.
And you can?
Yeah.
Okay.
Much to your delight.
We can keep all the cod this time, apparently. I don't know, it must be something to do with his quotas.
Can you see that line there in the sea? One side, you have to keep all the cod. And the other side, you can't keep any. See it? Can you see it? Yeah. It's real.
On top of the hardships associated with being a fisherman, the complex regulations about what you can and can't catch in different sea areas have shocked the celebrities.
It's just absolute pointless law. It doesn't make any sense at all.
If we're catching fish, let's eat it. We're catching fish to throw away. And that was heartbreaking.
For years, British fishermen have been angered by European controls on what they can and can't catch.
If you spoke to 90% of fishermen, they would say they voted for Brexit. And the main reason is to get out the common fisheries policy.
Having finally found a big haul of fish in an area where he can legally keep it, Skipper Alan sees his chance to make up for lost time.
What we're going to do now is we're going to shoot the single net. We're going to hammer them right into the cod end. We can keep you guys out of your beds till Thursday morning.
Fuck you. Hey, Skipper!
Oh, me.
It's now 2 p.m. and there's no time to waste. The nets need to go out fast. And this time, thanks to Shane's help, the single net can be put back to use. This larger net is better suited to these shallower waters and targeting big shoals of haddock.
The net we mended earlier, the floats, the balls that we attached, is now going to get shot. Quite literally, my balls are on the line.
Below deck, Anthony and Ben are taking care of the gutting, while the crew are busy with the net.
We're allowed to do the cod today.
Well, it's nice to be able to take this home, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, nice fish, some of these.
Cod is beautiful fish. I mean, it was nice you weren't having to chuck this stuff back.
Jeez, the biggest one of these we've brought.
Lovely bit of fish, though.
I mean, it's just such a nice big bit of cod.
The first part of the trip, we couldn't catch cod. The second part, we could. And it made a massive difference. It just made your hauls a lot bigger. We could land pretty much everything that we caught. That was refreshing, for sure.
On deck, Shane's making sure everything goes smoothly with his newly mended nets.
One of the big drums had this knocking or clanging sound, and to me it was just like a dry bear. So I kind of found a nipple that hadn't been greased, found a grease gun, popped it in, and the banging is gone. That's probably the highlight of my trip, weirdly enough, was problem solving something on the Genesis.
Back on track with Shane's mended single net in the water, and knowing they're in a good area for fish, the Genesis tows for a tense 5 hours. A winning haul could now change their fortunes. Their strategy has now paid off. It's the biggest haul of the trip.
That's the baby. Yeah, look at that one, eh?
It's looking sweet.
Sharpen your knives.
Seems good, doesn't it?
It's better.
I'm not sure what it is. I think there's a mixture.
A mixture of fish is a good result, as it spreads the risk at market where prices can fluctuate wildly.
Lucky now, lucky I'm on cooking duties tonight.
The Genesis set sail 9 days ago, with a target of 1,000 boxes of fish. But the strict regulations have meant she has had to throw much of her catch away, and the target has slipped further and further out of reach. But now, with the crew and celebrities pulling together as a team...
Getting slightly better.
At long last...
Still a bit to go yet.
There's a glimmer of hope.
We all had a connection. Before you know it, we found ourselves as one massive entity that ran this boat.
Did anyone ever tell you you're quite pretty when you smile?
There are 24 hours of fishing still to go, and everything to play for. 10 days ago, three celebs came aboard as new crew members. Since then, they've hauled, gutted, and packed fish up to 4 times a day around the clock. But they've also started to understand what it is that fishermen get out of this brutal job.
You wouldn't think it was 12:30 at night at all. Still have a bright hue running through the sky. It's quite amazing.
Just being out in the middle of nowhere with nothing. There's something amazing about being alone like that. You're vulnerable, you're left to the elements, and that's magical.
They've seen fishermen taking responsibility for the things that they catch by mistake.
Look at the size of that monster. Fucking hell.
And the care taken to set them free.
It's a big skate.
When you catch it with a big skate, to put them back is giving them a chance to live. It's nice to see a softer side of them, you know.
Monster, that wasn't it?
It was. He swam away as well, which is good.
That's good.
And they've come to appreciate the diversity of marine life in UK waters.
What are they?
Starfish.
Oh, good God. Get rid of it.
He's shitting himself. Big man. Scared of a little starfish.
You see that?
Oh, yeah, it's a lesser spotted dogfish.
It's got big. I haven't seen the big dots before. The fish was an exciting bit for me. I mean, seeing all that wonderful fresh fish. and such wonderful varieties.
It's fascinating with all this fish around the islands, isn't it? What's the jelly stuff?
Squid eggs. They're good to eat.
You can eat them.
That looks like you just masturbated in your hand.
Oh, please.
I'm off.
It's dawn, and the celebrities have just 24 hours left at sea.
Morning.
Morning.
The fisherman's routine of short naps between long shifts is becoming a real struggle.
The shift rotation has definitely been tough.
An instant energy bar. I noticed I was getting a little bit clumsier. Am I feeling fatigue? Well, yeah. I still have that adrenaline rush to keep going, even though if I'd sat down, I probably would have fallen asleep.
I'd say turning right when I'm gonna go left.
My brain was just on autopilot.
How many halls to go? Deck the goddamn halls. Belch, oh holly. Fa-la-la-la, fucking la.
With fish finally coming in, Skipper Allen has a plan to squeeze in as many catches as possible before the end of the trip. And the celebrities aren't the only ones suffering from lack of sleep.
Sleep's probably the hardest thing. You don't get much.
Next time, change next time. Will it? Maybe another one. Oh my god!
You're always going to make the odd mistake. But as long as it's not too costly.
In these 10 days, the celebrities have had just a taste of the exhaustion that is routine for fishermen who do this all year round.
Speaking to Phil last night, he spends 3 weeks out of the month at sea. 3 weeks a month. How they do it.
I don't know how they survive. I really don't. They've got some crazy, crazy inner strength above and beyond what I could do.
If they stay awake today, the celebs will have been up for every haul. But with three more trawls to come, keeping up with the crew is going to be a tough task.
But this one and another three, I reckon, can probably squeeze three in, so my mind is far from thinking glory to the last day.
You have to go and do stuff to know stuff, to be alive. That's the bottom line, is to be alive. And sometimes you gotta hurt to be alive.
We're in a good area where we're at. It's a good mixture of fish. God save some monks.
It's not bad, is it?
Every fish they catch now is profit.
A good dolly mixture.
And the celebrities are determined to put in the hours for the sake of the crew, who in 10 days have become like family.
Isn't that? I was in control of that, yeah? And now you fucked it up.
You tell them, Anthony!
It was genuine warmth and friendship.
You even got the Scottish out now. Wait.
I wanted to take away all the fancy airs and graces and become one of them.
Thanks, Ward.
Okay.
I'm going to crack on with the gutting. You coming?
There's an offer you cannot refuse. Ben Cohen says to you, want to come for some gutting, Shane? Ooh, yeah. Now, that's the kind of stuff I like to hear.
You trying to be romantic?
Yeah, a little bit.
With big catches finally coming in, pressure is building on the gutting line. The fish can only be sold for the best prices if it's cleaned and packed in peak condition.
What's up, Larry? It's coming.
Over 24 hauls, the celebrities have helped gut and pack around 700 boxes of fish. 53-year-old Jamie is an old hand at training up novice trawlermen in the job he's done his whole adult life.
Hey, Shane. Ice. Perfect. Ready you go.
Jamie had an amazing way of teaching without being a teacher. He was so, so lovely as a man and so wanted everybody to do well.
Oh, I never been any bloody good at jigsaws.
The strength of that guy, his strength is unbelievable, mentally and physically.
Phil, are they small monk fish?
Yeah, just keep putting them in, you're okay.
Keep going.
Philip is the skipper's nephew. At just 24, he's already an experienced trawlerman.
If you couldn't get a job as a singer, I'd easily get a job as a fisherman.
He hopes eventually to become a skipper.
Yeah, 10 years' time, Philip will be well and truly in charge of that ship, I think. Oh. He's the master of his own destiny there, I think, eh?
Thank you.
He's what the industry needs. The next generation of fishermen.
It's the penultimate haul.
Just do the damn thing.
The three celebrities have got to grips with many of the tasks on board the boat.
Come see, come sir.
But Anthony has resisted the job that's a rite of passage for any trawlerman, tying the critical cod end knot.
Rightly, it's your turn.
Oh, bollocks it is.
But if he thinks he's going to get away with it, he hasn't reckoned on Skipper Alan.
What an Anthony.
Come on, Chief.
Now you start us off. Why did I let Alan make me do that cod knot?
Yeah. I'm confused now. Yeah, that one.
I just thought, you know what? I probably should do this.
You're pretty good. I ain't tight.
Tight.
It's
a staff. It's a rat's ass.
Thank you very much.
Anthony. Hey,
you.
Anthony's knot will bring in the last catch of the trip.
Are you going to trust that knot for the last catch?
I'm a bit nervous, are you?
A bit.
For the last time, guys, chuck it away!
It's just after midnight, and the final haul is about to come in after 5 hours of towing.
God, could have slept through today, I tell you.
I'll be honest with you, I'm hoping for a good haul for the lads, but selfishly I'd like a small one to get it done.
Let's see how it goes though. There ain't no celebrations just yet, until she's all unlock and we're heading for shore.
I've got it, on the last day I finally got the right direction, it's this way. I usually head that way.
This haul will reveal if Anthony's cod end knot has managed to catch any fish.
Anthony.
Hi.
You think the cod end knot's going to be okay?
My cod end's fine, thanks, want to have a look?
Anthony loves a bonder. He really does.
That's when I wanted to get back to bed. Look at the fuckers.
We wouldn't have finished with a bang. I think we'll finish with a
whimper.
The final celebrity haul is only average.
There is an upside, Anthony.
If the cod end stays.
No, the cod end not held.
With the last haul safely aboard, finally, the exhausted celebrities are allowed to get ready for bed.
Do you want my overalls?
Do you think it fits me?
Nearly over.
Not over yet, lads. He's already given his clothes away. Tomorrow still, tomorrow.
Tomorrow, they will return to land with their catch, and they will finally find out if their trip has been a success or a failure.
What do you think is all over? It's not. It's going to be a shambles. Ah!
It's early morning on the last day, and the celebrity crew are heading for shore.
Scraps at harbour, scraps at harbour, scraps at harbour, Genesis, Channel 12. All clear to come in.
Having steamed overnight, they'll arrive at Scrabster, a major fishing hub on the north coast of Scotland, where their catch can be sold.
Okay, we'll see you shortly.
Completing their voyage is a proud moment for the celebrities, after all the doubts about how hard they'd really work.
Well, none of us have shirked any duties, none of us have hidden in our bunks. You know, we've all got on with it and done our bit, you know, some better than others.
I must confess, there was many times I did want to hide in my bunk.
I know that I was ready for it to be over after the second day. So I was very thankful that we were seeing dry land again.
We have got up for every single haul. You had to do it out of pure respect, because this is what they do, so get up and fucking do it with them.
We have arrived, yeah.
But there's no time to celebrate. The fish must be unloaded into the quayside fish market, ready for sale. Landing day is the hardest day of all for a trawler's crew, calling for long hours of strenuous work. Only when that's over will the celebrities find out if they've done enough to make a profit and if their trip has been a success.
I'm just looking at their boys. I think they're a bit burned out, to be honest. Well, not them all.
Where are you going with the rounds? They've only got three columns, you're going three high. Oh, you got another one top.
Hunting is just the same as the day he came away. He's just...
Come on, Alan. Come on.
Good. Can't have time to chat. Have a coffee morning.
It's unbelievable.
Genesis set sail with a target of 1,000 boxes of mixed fish. But at the halfway stage, it seems she'd do well to hit 700. The final count, 870.
Target was 1,000. And all the complications. Not bad.
It's a good result for such a troubled voyage.
All credit to Alan, he's managed to catch fish. And whether it be small or it may be a large catch or medium catch, he's caught fish.
Come on, man! Hey! Eh? Can't I get the stuff?
Take back, oi, take back everything I just said. He's a horrible person.
Complete.
Complete.
I see bacon and egg sandwich in hand.
Despite falling short of their target, if the fish fetch a good price, the celebrity voyage could still make serious money.
Auction's coming up.
There's no more we can do.
Yeah, they're going round with the pricing now. They're testing everything, looking at everything.
Hope they get some good money on the boxes. Top price, if we can get them. What's the price of fish? What's the price of fish, man?
The boxes of fish are auctioned one species at a time. Prices for fish can vary wildly and can mean huge profits or catastrophic losses.
Selected monks then, you only have 160 again to start, mate. 160 and 2, 160 and 4, 182. We all done in 2.
The monkfish Up first, sell well.
1, 9, and 6. I'm bad. We all done. 1, 9, and 6.
96. Good money. Just be careful if you're not in the auction. You'll end up with 10 bucks a month.
Nearly £200 a box is a decent price for monkfish.
Box and a half of better haddocks there than 2 and 4.
But will Alan's strategy of targeting haddock pay off?
140 and 4, 140 and 6, 140 and 8.
It's good news.
And 2, 1, 5 and 2 is bid there then.
Haddock is in short supply at the market.
Big money for haddocks, for small haddocks. That's really expensive. Right?
They sell for double the usual amount.
It'd have been heart-wrenching to have just covered your costs on a 10-day trip like that, but they made money.
Hitting the market when prices are high has turned things around right at the last.
I think we did all right. It's true. It's true, aren't they?
He said, yeah, we're okay. A little twinkle in his eye, and I thought, yeah, we've cracked it.
It adds up to thousands of pounds of profit for Genesis and her crew.
It really isn't about how much you land. It's about hitting the right market.
There's just one more job left to do. The skipper has to decide whether his new recruits are worthy of a share of the money.
We've made it.
It's the ultimate measure of their contribution to the boats.
Cheers, guys. Trawlermen.
Before I met any of the celebrities, I thought they'd be pretty hopeless, to be honest. I thought they'd be a liability. I thought they would cost us money and time. Basically, I thought they'd just be a bit of a pain in the arse, if I'm being honest.
Right, you've been through a full 10 days with us. The celebrity ballast.
Whoa! The ballast!
I couldn't actually see a celebrity making it as a fisherman. No chance.
If they get paid, the celebrities earn the right to call themselves trawlermen. If they haven't pulled their weight, they'll get nothing.
But it turns out you're not ballast after all. You're doing really, really well.
I thought you was going to come in and work through the day and then take the night off.
Every hall you've been up, you've done really well.
Yeah.
Must say. So we've decided you guys are going to get a share along with the rest of the crew.
Yeah, that's very kind of you.
I never believed they'd manage to do what they did.
Cheers, boys.
The celebrities have managed to impress some of the toughest men in Britain.
You are now officially newbie trawlermen.
Yay! To be accepted, that was the payoff.
I wanted to say something, thank fuck that's over.
A fisherman's life is definitely not for me. Hell of an experience. Humbling, exhausting. It was an amazing experience meeting you guys, and thank you very much. It's a memory that will last with me for forever.
You boys are cut from a different cloth. Like, it's not like the rest of the men that kind of travel this world.
What I know, what I experienced, what I went through, that's one of the toughest things I've ever done in my life. And I've been through some stuff in life.
So, my wages, whatever they are, I want to give it to Phil. The next generation. And that's where my check goes. To you, Phil.
Yeah. Right, I love it.
That's a good speech.
I love it.
I'll get you right. Honestly. Yeah.
Nobody's mentioned Louis, Marley and Willie because you've also been fantastic.
Please.
And I think
awesome guys.
Awesome, hard-working guys working from trawl to trawl, not taking a break.
Yeah.
And I want to say, brilliant. But everyone, I mean, Jamie, you know, you're a bit older than me. It was probably one of the most thrilling experiences of my life. It was one of the hardest things I've ever done in my life. And it was one of the most enjoyable things I've done in my life because, you know, the camaraderie. The fact is, it's been a blast. I mean, probably, I don't know, I'm just excited, I'm young and feel like I've been reborn. Would I do it again? Yes. In a heartbeat.